Mr. Luca Campanello from he's a projects and innovation manager Erion, Italy. So welcome, Luca. And any questions, of course, still put them in the Q&A so we can ask them later on in the panel discussion. Luca, the floor is yours. You are muted.
Thank you. So I'm going to show you how the system is working in Italy, and then presenting some details about the Italian situation and about our extended producer responsibility scheme. I would like to start from the numbers and make a comparison between our reality and the reality of Africa. You can see in Italy we have almost 35% of return rate. So the collection rate of we compare to the put on the market is almost one third of the total. If we look to countries like Kenya, we found numbers of 1%. In general, in Africa, we have from 1 to 4%. So the situation it could sound very different between our system and the system that there is in Africa. Maybe during my presentation, we will find some point of contact. As Ibukun was saying, also in Italy, we have an all actor approach. So the management of we is not in the full responsibility of take-back schemes. Municipalities and retailers can decide to give we to take-back schemes, APR schemes, or to other actors. So this is one of the reasons why the collection rate is not very high, because it is clear that if an actor that is not an APR scheme is managing we, he will not report these quantities. Quantities collected in Italy are just reported came just from 99% came from extended producer responsibility schemes. The collection in Italy it is done by five groups, from cooling and freezing till lamps. We have a competitive system. So there is not only one scheme, Erion, but there are 13 extended producer responsibility schemes. For managing the competition, which has good points and bad points, of course, good points could be the fact that there is an extreme research to reduce the cost and a push for improving the service. This competition needs to be coordinated. It is coordinated by a clearinghouse, which is responsible to organize a level playing field between take-back schemes. Let me now, in the second half of my presentation, tell you about our company and what do we do. These are our values. The ownership of our scheme, it is only of a producer of electronic waste and electronic products and batteries. We want as priority to guarantee quality of the treatment. We make our fees, so the contribution, the visible fee, it is visible, it is public on our website, so, and it is equal for all the producers. We commit to innovation, to awareness, to change the behavior of consumers, and to transparency. These are our numbers. We have more than 2,000 members, and we manage every year more than 300,000 tons of waste. The group is made by different schemes dedicated to this different value chain. the one for we, the one for professional we, which has different needs in respect of the needs of the household producer, the one for batteries and the e-mobility, and the one for packaging. The economic value generated, it is almost 90 million of euro every year. We are by law a non-profit, non-for-profit consortium, so we need to reach the stability of the cost and of the revenues. Why this amount of this value could sound strange? Because treating we, even if it is a laptop, even if there is value, is a cost, because there is a big and long value chain. So municipalities needs to be remunerated for the collection activities. Logistic operator also. Treatment could get value from the recycling of materials, but then there is the labor cost. And so at the end, every stream has a cost. This cost is paid by the visible fees, and the fees, as I mentioned, are public for transparency. And just going to the end, our stakeholders are listed in the presentation. We have many services offered to our producer to go together with them in circular economy strategies. The challenges that now we are facing, it is increasing collection, of course, but then all the challenges related to circular economy, from preparation for reuse to the second life of the batteries. For tackling these challenges, we are working together with different, many partners in Europe, research organization, industrial partners, to find solution for the recycling, for the digitalization, and last thing, it is communication activities, big communication activities. Just in 3 months, more than 300 articles were public on the press, social activities, a dedicated website dedicated to consumers, and newsletter, and big presence on the media. Big studies published. One that I recommend, it is a studies with the good ideas for extended producer responsibility schemes. Good ideas that came from more than 10 years of experience from the European extended producer responsibility schemes. And then the sustainability report, in which we present the results of our activity. Thank you very much. I hope you will have many questions for me, and I will be happy to answer.
Thank you so much, Luca. Yes, I also hope we will have a lot of questions in the Q&A.